It was a fantastic match to kick off court one action today. Up next is the women's doubles, and it's Chen Xing Chen and Jia Yufan against Mike and Fruergaard and Sarah Thygesen. Looking at the women's doubles draw, and that match just now at the bottom half of this draw. This is section one. Was won by Iwanaga and Nakanishi. They'll face either Matsumoto Nagahara in an all-Japanese semi-final or Cross to open up. But that match also happening right now. And up at the top, it's Liu and Tan or Li and Liu. It's guaranteed Chinese quarterfinalist from that side. And it might just be an all-China quarterfinal simply due to the incredible historical and almost bordering legendary stats of the pair in red that are about to take to court. They are setting up, or if not, I mean, they may have already set up their own little niche in women's doubles history. Chen Xing Chen and Jia Yifan looking for a second consecutive Malaysia Open title, won last year. That was against Beikhana and Li Yu Lim, actually. And looking at it's an 8-0 lead here over Fruergaard and Thygesen. Last time they met was at the Sudirman Cup Finals in Suzhou. Well, we saw an upset just in that first game. I'll tell you one thing, and this is no disrespect to Mike and Sarah at all, but it's going to be a huge upset if Chen and Jia to manage to lose this. I don't think I'm sticking my neck out there. I mean, they're really that good. 26 years old, Chen Xing Chen, Neizhou in China. And this is a lot of ones next to their profiles. Jia Yifan. Interchangeable, of course. It's not really a question anymore of who's up at the net, who's at the back there. Are almost turning into two of the exact same player, and that just happens to be the best player that you need on a doubles court. 5'5", Chen Xing Chen, silver medalist at the Olympic Games, four-time world champions, dating back all the way to 2017, and that was their first results. Li Yu Lim and Chen Xing Chen. 46 minutes, 21-14, 21-14. Yep, those four world championships, 2017, 2021, 2022, and 2023. These are their opponents, Mike and Fruergaard. Said I hope I'm pronouncing those right. Steven Pedersen will be along later. Of course, he has the official right pronunciation for that. Sarah Thygesen. 32 years old, Fredericia, Denmark. And they were runner-up at the US Open. Didn't play in the Malaysia Open last year. 20 seconds. So this is going to be quite the last four. But Catherine Choi and Josephine Wu from Canada were their first opponents. And that was a good win. 32 minutes, 21-13, 21-11.
Bring us back to the court.
Umpire for this one, Mohamed Ezad Salman. Joined by our service judge, Fabio Beto. Machine that is Chen and Jia about to start itself into life again. Now, of course, if you've never seen these world champions in action, and what's it all about? Well, they're just very fast. I said they're interchangeable around the court. So you've got just very strong ability to attack and defend. But it's also their pattern of play and the way they interact.
On my right, Sarah Thygesen and Michael Fruergaard, Denmark. And on my left, Chen Jin Chen and Jia Yifan, China. Sarah Thygesen to serve to Jia Yifan. Love all, play.
Serve over. 11-13.
Solid opening rally for the Danes. They, of course, are going to be well aware of the massive arsenal of weapons that Chen and Jia have. I guess all you can really do when playing them is to just be on your toes.
Service over.
Very aware as possible. Oh. Once they get into that rhythm, Chen and Jia send such fluid movement between them. So accurate, so responsive, and we can very easily overpower opponents if, of course, they get into that rhythm. And that was a good interception there by Chen Xing Chen.
Challenge unsuccessful, one challenge remaining. So, 14-12.
Three, one.
Unsighted and serve.
15-12.
Single state free challenge. Will lose their ability to challenge. Great to have that ability, not just for the players, but also for the umpire as well. Use that disputed technology. Look at that. Too fast, I think. That explains that very strange look that Chen Xing Chen gave the umpire, because I think she knew. Look at that from a crouch position. Picked up nicely by Chen. Jia Yifan at the back. It's a little inkling of what I was talking about. So fast.
13-18.
Good pressure by Fruergaard.
6-2.
It's about attacking intent. That's effectively what you have to do. I mean, if you're playing one of the best attacking pairs in the world, you need to up your attacking ante as well. That's exactly
what Poison was doing. Six.
And judge, wipe the court, please. Chen, quick towel. Yeah.
That's a good point. Well, they've studied their tapes for sure. Played out the rally, and then what a shot. That would have come straight out of Chen and Zhao's book. Fun, but right now giving as good as they get, the Danes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please do not use flash photography.
Distracting
the player's concentration. Dilarang menggunakan flash photography. Ini mengganggu konsentrasi pemain. Terima kasih.
8-5.
Great movement by Chen and Zhao. Started with Chen up front, Zhao at the back. And instinctively moved to a flat formation there at the end.
Chen,
wonderful play on the left and right side. It's where they've been looking to score their points. It's been working well for them.
Second game.
9-6. Up against the world champions, that is. Very good play.
2-0. Service over. 1-0.
Service over 10-6.
good pressure. Needs to be.
Seven, 10.
Error. Four-time medalist at the European Championships. Fruergaard Thygesen. Solid enough output from the world champions, but some good moments from the Danish opponents. So back on court, the second phase of game one. And it's good to see that the Danish pair not overawed at all by the
11-7 play.
Challenge at hand.
Silver, 5-2.
Almost caught out there. Oh, had to reset herself.
Service over.
Luck of the net.
8-11. One. Passage of seven. Passage of
6-2.
Chen. You want? Sarah, you want the change?
Short, the drop shot, and it's a 2-point deficit. Denied.
Service over. 10, 12.
That's good. Consistent pressure.
Service over. 9, 4.
Defense looking a little bit shaky today. Chen and Zhao. Point.
10, 4.
The world number 20s have stuck to their guns. It's going on as well. So tied up at 12. And Chen and Jia at this current moment looking far from what we usually see from them. But that's down to some solid, solid commitment from the pair in blue.
11-4 interval. Service over.
Nice round ahead by Jia Yifan.
13-12.
So they are managing to still, and that's the mark of true champions, I guess, even if they are a little bit shaky, they still know what to do to create that lead. They've got one.
11-4.
And now the points beginning to fall again.
Yes,
they'd like. You could say, if you look at their general output, they do play a lot of tournaments every year. As a pair, Chen and Jia do favour quick points, quick kills, sharp on the aggression. So I guess you could, from that, infer that your best chances would be to do exactly this, engage them in a long rally. So always looking for that win. Point. Keep those lifts coming.
16-12.
Stay there from
Fruergaard. 17-12.
And in all honesty, they haven't made that many mistakes, the Danes, at all.
Service over, 12-6.
And now a couple in quick succession.
18.
Now you've got to fancy Chen and Jia to take this first game from here. Our longest rally so far, 28 shots, and that's exactly what I mean. If you can keep Chen and Jia longer rallies like that, then of course there is a better chance. But you have to keep them safe rallies. Can't give them any kind of opportunity to kill, because they will, and they're very, very talented at doing that, grounding that shuttle as fast as possible. So it has been a good output from Fruergaard and Thygesen so far. I think this first game might be beyond them. But let's see, as I said. I remember saying the same thing about Han Yue against Jiao Min. A combination of slight collapse, great resolute firing from Jiao Min, and she came through the winner. Famous upset. Game one, match one, I should say.
Thank you.
now 30 change.
And a mistake. And that's going to be 7 game points.
Game point 30.
So they got that first game in the end, and they'll take it. But certainly not the most complete we've seen them as a pair. And a lot of chances in there for Fruergaard and Thygesen to cut in. But in the end, Chen and Jar doing just enough to take that first game.
Sarah.
So players back on court for game two, and very much for the Danes it's going to be trying to get a little bit more intensity into those attacks. They did
second
find
game.
Enough Le chances.
Play.
And Chen and Zhao not 100%, so there is an opportunity here. Chen and Zhao will be playing into the drift.
One love.
It's an easy kill for Zhao in front, pushing herself through. Finding a good angle from that position off on the left. The 3-1 lead for Chen and Zhao. Well, they have such high standards of excellence after all the titles and achievements that they've racked up. I think that's exactly what themselves and their coaches would have had a chat about, because now this is a far more solid output from them.
Okay.
Well, discussion going on right now. I think it's looking for God to just clarify who's doing what. Well, it's often the case that when you are behind, you do try that little bit more ambition. Could lead to more mistakes. In that safe area of reliability and quality, and then you can start progressing. What a shot by
Chen.
Maybe we'll see a close up of that. Look at that. Another really, really unique skill.
Service over.
You can play shots from anywhere. That was just behind the head off the right shoulder. Just think about that. Just think of exactly where that shuttle was when she took it. Still managed to go on this right. 2-6. Deep serve.
Service over. 16-15.
Great movement by Chen and Zhao.
3-6.
I'm not surprised at the accuracy of that.
Service over. 13-20.
Having that presence and has that psychological factor to their opponents, and Chen and Zhao definitely scare the life out of you at times, and you have to get over that, the fact that they're the ones on the other side of the net, play your best game.
9-3.
But just the depth of their achievement and depth of their ability as well. It just gives that extra tiny millisecond of doubt before you choose your shot.
Can
make all the difference. Oh, that's absolutely on the line. Fantastic shot. 10-3.
10-3.
They've certainly tied it up. Second mid-game interval, and for Chen and Zhao, this is the kind of point accrual that they do like.
Final game.
11, 3, play.
19, 18.
Second phase of game two. And it's a strong buffer for Chen and Zhao to work off. Saying that, that was a great angle for Fruergaard.
4-11.
Match ball 3-18.
Mistakes against them. But this is a very familiar scoreline for Chen and Zhao. Zhao in front with the creative. Oh, look at that movement. That's beautiful. Creative force at the back, now more flat. Chen takes over. I think on the day, Chen's probably the player that has been guilty of a few more errors from their benchmark of success. Let's not forget. Chen Fan has been pretty much on it. Sarah. But it's certainly not been a question of Zhao Yifan having to bail out her partner in any way. Just the odd extra mistake from Chen. That's allowed situations like this. Services for the Danes. Chance for them to attack. Turn by Zhao Yifan off the serve. Caused enough problems, put enough pressure. Danes to nice hook in, using the height advantage.
Eight. 5 foot 8.
Sarah. Average height. Around this court, all four players around about 5'5", 5'6". Oh, what a disguise.
9-13.
Didn't work out once again, as you can see. Bit of frustration on Chen's face. Third time, I think she's tried that disguise drop. Didn't work out. Just a couple of shots here and there not working out for them. It's been a great comeback from the Danes. 11-3 down. Yeah. great angle.
11, 13.
So a good run of points from the Danes. And Chen and Jia, well, I'm never going to say they're in trouble from what they can do, but certainly not in terms of the scoreline, what they're used to. This James and Chen again with another mistake. And you've got that advantage, and in this case it's a chance to tie it all up. Got to be a little bit more careful.
Mixed double, Matthias Terry and Emily Megalin, Denmark versus Yuta Watanabe.
Soft hands for she's in control right now. Still, Dane's doing well. Keeping it tight, playing out the rallies.
30, 14.
As I said, if you can get over that initial attack by Chen and Jiao, then there is a chance if you can engage them in the longer rallies. Chen Xing Chen looking a little bit fallible today. Still don't think that's going to be enough. They should power through, but it's close in the second. Isn't that just badminton that the net court should come in? Decide that 14 all. Well, we saw it in the first match with Han Yue against Yao Jiamin. If you just start getting a little bit complacent, which essentially is what Han Yue did, then it starts off as just a comeback by your opponent. But in Han Yue's case, it ended up with a match win, a famous upset as well. Got to stay focused.
Out. Service over.
That's a shame.
15. 14.
No, we've got a bit too much.
10. 9.
Just trying to be a bit too clinical on the serve. Good pick up by Chen. Oh, what a shot by Chinese fun. Wow.
16-14.
Off the backhand as well. Straight down the line, pinpoint accurate. Well, I don't want to say he can breathe easier, because that's exactly what got them into this situation. They were 11-3 up at the break. So for them to be at 17-14, well, that's going to be a bit of a discussion afterwards. Good. Again, good play by the Danes, just keeping it open. And it's a mistake. It's benefited them well. That's how they've been progressing.
15, 17.
Ready to play.
Important serve. With a double take, still manages to connect.
Service over.
Mike in this 18-15. 18-15. Better from Chen Sing Chen.
19.
Step
15.
Back. Hook into mid-court.
14.
Ready. Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Matthias Thierry and Amalie Bagelung, Denmark.
To see so many fans in attendance. Still the morning session, just got past 11 a.m. local time here on day three.
17-19.
Still, they're held at 19, Chen and Zhao. Jaifan, that would have been bread and butter for her. 19. You would have thought in the right place at the right time, as she usually is, but this time snatches at it. 18-19. Again, Chen and Zhao looking for a way in. And they've done enough to force a couple of match points.
Match point 18.
Direction,
19,
just not the right length.
20.
Oh, this is a fantastic opportunity for the Danes. If they can take this to extra points, then that should be enough. Chen and Zhao hardly ever have to delve into that area of the game. Oh, they've done it.
20.
They've bought themselves a lifeline. They fought hard in the second game. I think the expression on Chen and Zhao's face says it all. 11-3 up, remember, at the interval.
4-3. 21-20.
So it is a third match point for the world champions. And it's a mistake in the end. Chen Xingchen just held off on that serve, played out the moment, and it worked in her favour. Michael Fruergaard went a little bit too low.
Match so, 21-13.
22-20, couldn't have said it better myself. That was 46 minutes. Challenge up. Continue their quest for back-to-back titles here at the Malaysia Open. Back at the Malaysia Open 2024, first Super 1000 event of the year, and in fact the first event of the HSBC BWF World Tour season for this year. Happening at the Axiata Arena and looking at Court 1, well, it's been some fascinating matchups for the first two matches. Now it's the mixed doubles, and former world champions Detchepon,